Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to all our participants in our NRA Press Club program. I am your host, Gary Singh Garewal. Our topic is how to unite a divided NRA people worldwide. This is the topic today. Pashaura Singh Ji, tell us.
Thank you. NRA Press Club ki or se सबसे पहले आप सबको संयुक्त किसान मोर्चा आंदोलन की जीत के लिए हार्दिक बधाई और शुभकामनाएं। शांतमयी आंदोलन की जीत का ये ताज़ा ऐलान एक ऐतिहासिक ऐलान है। आंदोलनकारियों को इस जीत का जश्न 8 दिसंबर को दुख्त हादसा ग्रस्त अपने उन बहादुर जवानों और जनरल चीफ ऑफ डिफेंस स्टाफ जनरल बिपिन रावत को श्रद्धांजलि देते हुए एक दिन के लिए मुलतवी करना पड़ा, जहां उनको देश प्रदेश में श्रद्धांजलियां पेश की जा रही हैं। हम उनको नमन भी करते हैं और उम्मीद भी करते हैं कि इस दुखद हवाई दुर्घटना के बारे में जो सरकार की तरफ से पड़ताल करी जा रही है, उसमें पाई गई सब कमजोरियां, गैलियां और गलतियों को पूर्ण रूप में सुधारा जाए, ताकि दोबारा कौम के इस तरह इतना भारी नुकसान ना झेलना पड़े। आज के टॉपिक हाउ टू यूनाइट ए डिवाइडेड एनआरआई कम्युनिटी और संयुक्त किसान मजदूर आंदोलन की अभी अभी हुई जीत के आपसी कनेक्शन के बारे, जो शांतमय तरीके से पंजाब से उठकर बनता बनता जन आंदोलन बन गया, दो बातें कहना चाहता हूँ। वरिष्ठ पत्रकार इस ऐतिहासिक आंदोलन को विश्व के जन हित में चले बड़े बड़े शांतमय आंदोलनों में शुमार करते वक्त इसे हिमालय जैसा ऊंचा सूचा और पवित्र आंदोलन मानते हैं। कुछ लोग तो इसे केवल आंदोलन की शुरुआत ही कहते हैं, जो भारत माता की दिलो जान से जय जयकार करने वाले मजदूर किसानों को मजबूर होकर करना पड़ रहा है, जिसे जवान भी जो मजदूर किसानों के ही बेटे बेटियां हैं देख रहे हैं। आजाद देश के लोकराज में उनकी अपनी सरकार के खिलाफ बेशक ऐसे आंदोलनों की जरूरत नहीं पड़नी चाहिए, लेकिन ये हुआ। अब देखना यह है कि इस आंदोलन की जीत की धमक जो देश प्रदेश में तो सुनाई दे रही है, क्या वो कुछ ही फासले पर दिल्ली संसद में भी ठीक से सुनाई दे सकेगी? और दूसरा, किसानों की नजर में जिन किसान विरोधी काले कानूनों को इस आंदोलन ने उसी संसद से रद्द करवाया है, क्या वो और ऐसे जन विरोधी कारपोरेट पक्षी कानून बनाने वालों को रोक पाएंगे? कुछ लोग समझते हैं कि इस आंदोलन की सबसे बड़ी प्राप्ति ये है कि देशवासियों की अनेकता में एकता और भाईचारक चेतना की बात, जो 100 साल पहले अमेरिका की इसी धरती से गदर पार्टी के नाम हमारे आप अपने और हमारे सबके पूर्वों के एनआरआई हिंदू मुस्लिम और सिख प्रवासियों ने मिलके उस समय की सबसे शक्तिशाली अंग्रेज हुकूमत के विरुद्ध पैदा की और देश आजाद हुआ, वो चेतना फिर से उमड़ आई है। वो नींद से जाग उठी चेतना जिसने राष्ट्रवाद की परिभाषा ही बदल डाली है, और ये बात निकली है तो दूर तक जाएगी, या कह लीजिए कि भारत के 14वें वर्तमान प्रधानमंत्री मोदी जी को वही बात दोबारा केवल सुनाई ही नहीं देती, सताने लगी है, जिसके बारे में गदर पार्टी के बानी बाबा सोहन सिंह भकना ने पहले प्रधानमंत्री पंडित जवाहरलाल नेहरू जी को 1950s में उस समय कहा था, जब गदरी देशभक्तों का वफद दिल्ली उनको मिलने गया था। बाबा भकना जी ने और बातों के साथ ये कहा था कि पंडित जी, आप हिंदुस्तान के आजाद हो जाने की बात करते हो, हम हिंदुस्तानियों की आजादी के लिए कह रहे हैं। कहते हैं कि पंडित जी केवल मुस्कुराए थे, कहा कुछ नहीं था और वक्त निकलता गया। लगता है हिंदुस्तान की आजादी के पौनी सदी बाद ही सही इस आंदोलन करके हिंदुस्तानियों की आजादी का आगाज भी अब हो चुका है, जो मोदी जी को सुनाई ही नहीं दिखाई भी देने लगा है, और वो नेहरू जी की तरह मुस्कुरा नहीं रहे। कहते हैं बेशक मोदी जी इस अनदेखी के लिए माफी मांग रहे हैं, परंतु इसका समाधान अब उनके बस में नहीं, क्योंकि वो कारपोरेट को ऐसा ना करने का वचन पहले दे चुके हैं। अजीब इत्तेफाक ये है कि ऐन इसी समय अमेरिका जिसके मॉडल पर मोदी सरकार बजिद है, उसके वाशिंगटन स्टेट के अपने शहर सियाटल की एक इंडियन बॉर्न नौजवान सोशलिस्ट सिटी काउंसलर कशामा सावंत कॉरपोरेट बैक्ड कैंडिडेट्स के खिलाफ लड़ी नहीं रही, वो जीत भी रही है। इस तरफ एंटी कॉरपोरेट आंदोलन का पहला अध्याय दिल्ली की दीवारों पर लिखा जा चुका है, पुस्तक बाकी है। ये कहकर खत्म करूंगा कि अगर ये आंदोलन ठीक ही जनहित आंदोलनों का हिमालय जैसा ऊंचा सूचा और पवित्र आंदोलन है, तो फिर भारत माता की आन बान शान के लिए इस हिमालय से भारतवासियों की आजादी की गंगा तो निकलनी ही चाहिए। हम विदेशों में रहते एनआरआई भाई बहनों को भी उस चेतना को आगे बढ़ाते हुए एक मुठ हो जाना चाहिए। एन उसी तरह जैसे ठीक 108 साल पहले अमेरिका की धरती से इंडियन इमिग्रेट्स ने गदर पार्टी के नाम से अनेकता में एकता बनाकर दिखाया था, और यही आज के विचार विमर्श का विषय है। बैक टू यू गैरी जी।
ओके जी, थैंक यू सर। विजय पाटल।
सो आई थिंक द टॉपिक इज हाउ डू वी यूनाइट द डिवाइडेड कम्युनिटी। लेट मी रिफ्रेज द टॉपिक। सो द टॉपिक आज का जो टॉपिक है जहाँ पे लेट्स यूनाइट द डिवाइडेड कम्युनिटी, I will question the topic. NRIs are not divided, meaning they are united when there is a cause. There are times when the celebrations are local and they will celebrate the local thing. And we see that in many, there's FIA celebration, right? So we are not fully divided. when there's a national thing that we have to address, we all come together, right? Today, when there was a national thing that happened, with Bipin Rawatji, a lot of other communities from Maharashtrian community, from Punjabi community, from Gujarati community, people came together to talk about it. So we are, I would say, probably not as united as we should be, but we need help on that. So मुझे ये कि बोलना है कि जब भी आपको हम लोग unity की बात करते हैं, तो I will keep this in the context of America and not Indian politics. क्योंकि इंडियन पॉलिटिक्स में जब हम लोग जाएंगे तो इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट, मेरा उतना बेस भी नहीं है, नॉलेज भी नहीं है, आई एम नॉट अप टू स्पीड कि इंडिया में क्या हो रहा है। बट यूनिटी के बारे में फार्मर्स के भी जो बात की साथ जी ने, तो आई एडमायर इट। फार्मर्स हैव बीन पार्ट ऑफ अवर कंट्री, इनफैक्ट हम लोग सब एट सम पॉइंट टाइम हम लोग फार्मर थे। मेरे 4 जनरेशन पहले वो फार्मर थे, फार्मर्स एग्रीकल्चर वॉज अवर bread and butter in India, har ek ke liye. Then you get into education and defense and all that. So definitely, I think we have to do it. We have to support farmers. Farmers ko support karna chahiye. There's a topic of farmer suicide, which Gary ji, aapke note mein bhi tha, ki farmer suicide karte. Maharashtra mein, I think it's a big, I come from Maharashtra. So Maharashtra mein, it's a big problem, farmer suicide kar rahe. So NRL log, hum log kya kar sakte as a NRL community, right? So, NRI community is very powerful when it comes to money, desire, motivation. We do it out of hobby. We do it out of passion. We are, so Maharaj jo sab kuch hai, they're happy in their own life. So they have everything that they need, luxury hai, sab kuch hai. But jab in Bharat ke liye koi karta hai NRI, so they do it out of their passion. So talk about poverty, talk about education, right? Education mein hum log NRI community saath mein aake, there is money. और पैसा इंडिया में कुछ गर्ल को हम लोग पढ़ाएंगे, राइट, अडॉप्ट अ चाइल्ड ऐसा करेंगे। सो आई वुड से कि अडॉप्ट अ फार्मर, एक फार्मर को हम लोग अडॉप्ट कर सकते हैं जहाँ पे अपने पता है कि ये फार्मर का इकोनॉमिक कंडीशन ठीक नहीं है, राइट, दे आर स्ट्रगलिंग बिकॉज ऑफ सम इश्यूज, सो मे बी वी कैन डू अ कैंपेन टू सपोर्ट देम आउट। सो एंड मैसेजिंग, सो जब भी हम लोग मैसेजिंग करते हैं तो मैसेजिंग हैज टू बी अबाउट यूनिटी, हम लोग साथ में मिलकर सब कुछ कैसे कर सकते हैं, राइट, एज अपोज टू मराठी कम्युनिटी सेलिब्रेटिंग दिस, एंड एज आई मेंशन अर्लियर, राइट, शिव जयंती, व्हेन यू सेलिब्रेट शिव जयंती, छत्रपति शिवाजी महाराज जयंती, वी आर ऑनरिंग ऑल इंडियन नेशनल हीरोज, महाराणा प्रताप, महाराजा रणजीत सिंह, राजा कृष्ण देव राय, फ्रॉम ऑल ओवर भारत वी आर ऑनरिंग एवरीवन। और एक छोटी सी चीज है, बट द छोटी सी चीज विल क्रिएट अ गुड इंप्रेशन फॉर अ नेक्स्ट जनरेशन। अपने यहाँ पे जो नई पीढ़ी है उनको ये समझना चाहिए कि अपने सब इंडिया भारतीय लोग ये साथ में है, यूनाइटेड है। That will be just my comment on this.
Okay, beautiful. Vijay Patel ji, very good. Let me go to Jeevan Gill ji. Jeevan Gill.
I will try. Thank you, Gill ji. नमस्कार जी. पहले तो सभी को जैसे पशौरा सिंह ने बोला है, हमको उससे चाहे यूनिटी का मुद्दा इसीलिए इन्होंने चुना है ताकि हम उनसे कुछ ना कुछ लर्न कर सके. कैसे उन्होंने पीसफुली ये आंदोलन चलाया, उसके उसको उसकी उसकी तर्ज से हमको यहाँ पे भी. आई एम बिलोंग टू ए स्मॉल टाउन in Canada is known as a Windsor. It is the fourth diverse city in Canada. Yahan pe India ki hum baat karte hain, wahan pe sabhi states ke aadmi behan bhai rehte hain. Baki bhi country, other countries, 108 countries ke people living in Windsor. So it is one of the diverse city. वहां जब हम एक दूसरे कम्युनिटी से बात करते हैं, उससे अलाइन करना समटाइम इजी हो जाता है. अपने जो इंडिया की, जैसे कामनी जी भी कह रहे थे, समटाइम्स वी हैव अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ इश्यूज लाइक व्हाई वी डिडंट हैव अ इंडियन गुजराती एसोसिएशन. वी हैव अ गुजराती एसोसिएशन, वी डोंट हैव अ इंडियन गुजराती एसोसिएशन. सो उसको एक लाइन में लेके आना. सभी जैसे कि हम In North America, we say like diversity is our strength. I believe in like India is a bigger diversity than anybody else. Like, agar us cheez ko hum yahan pe continue kare, to we can achieve lot more. Jaise Patil ji ne bhi kai mudde uthaye hain, jiski humko bahut zarurat hai. Hum us pe kaam karna chahte hain, but sometimes we didn't get the support from the back. Kyunki wahan ka jo पॉलिटिकल सिस्टम है, यहाँ पे हमको आजादी है बोलने की, कुछ करने की, जैसे भी है, वहां पे वो हमको कट हो जाता है. इसी को हम कैसे अप्रोच करें ताकि हमारे लिंक जो है, कोई पंजाब से आया है, कोई गुजरात से आया है, दे ऑलवेज वांट टू फ्लोरिश देयर स्टेट्स और विलेजेस और देयर सिटीज. उसके लिए वही बात होती है भी हम क्या कर सकते हैं जहाँ पे, क्योंकि जैसे इसमें भी देखो भी जो पहले मैंने बोला है कि एजुकेशन से हमको बहुत कुछ लर्न करना है. लर्न करने के लिए कैसे भाइयों ने जहां से फॉरेन से भी सपोर्ट गई एंड इट वेंट पीसफुली, लाइक दैट इज वन फर्स्ट थिंग इज वी आर ऑल ह्यूमन बीइंग्स. देन डिविजन स्टार्ट कमिंग फ्रॉम व्हेन वी स्टार्टिंग एंगेजिंग रिलीजियसली or culturally or politically. So that will create a division between us that we have to eliminate. We live in a beautiful country in North America. We should be proud of that one. We should be proud of our Indian culture, but we should be more proud of what these countries given to us. And instead of fighting between each other on different issues, we should be eliminate that. And more of we should be first thing is like we should be united here, and then we can see what we can hum piche Bharat ke liye kya kar sakte hain, ya unki state mein ya unke village mein kisi bhi mudde pe hai, chahe farmers hai, chahe education hai, chahe healthcare hai, usme hum we can put input in that one to make that improvement.
Thank you Manoj ji. Manoj Shah, Dr. Manoj Shah ji.
हेलो नमस्ते. मैं भी हिंदी में बोलने का थोड़ा ट्राई चौकस कर सकता हूँ.
ठीक है, गुड.
मेरी हिंदी गुजराती हिंदी इंग्लिश की कंबाइन होगी. आई जस्ट वांट टू फर्स्ट मेक श्योर, मैंने सोचा था आज का टॉपिक है यूनिटी ऑफ एनआरआईज. सो first thing I think is unity requires one thing under which everybody can unite. So I think that we all have to agree with that one principle that will just unite everybody. Right now, what I heard, all points were points of division. They were not point of unity. So very important thing. So what do we think will unite all Indians? That's what, if you are thinking, we are not thinking about Indians in India. मैं तो सोचता हूँ कि इंडियन जो अमेरिका में रहते हैं, उनको यूनाइट करने की बात है, तो ऐसा कौन सा पॉइंट है जो सबके लिए इम्पोर्टेंट है? थोड़े के लिए वी पीपल टॉक्ड अबाउट समथिंग इन पॉलिटिक्स, समथिंग टॉक अबाउट डिफरेंट कास्ट, डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ रीजन, डिफरेंट लैंग्वेजेस के गुजराती और सिख और पंजाबी और महाराष्ट्रियन, देयर इज ऑल आर काइंड ऑफ सेपरेट थिंग. द वन थिंग वी नीड टू नो इज विच वन पॉइंट सो वी विल कम अल्टीमेटली टू द कल्चर एज अवर यूनाइटिंग पॉइंट. So we have to know what is our culture that we want to go after and kind of unite under that banner or umbrella. Now, I'm not sure if everybody agree with that or not, but I think we have to first come up with the point under which we are going to unite. One thing is being Indian. So being Indian is not just coming from one state or one part of India. Being Indian is following the cultural, actually, tradition of India. And anybody could be Indian who follows those tradition. So, मैं जानना चाहूँगा आप सबको कि अगर आप बाहर जाते हैं, किसी को मिलते हैं who is not Indian, they will always look you as an Indian first. And they will not call you, oh, are you Gujarati or are you Maharashtrian or not. Yeah, maybe right. For Sikhs, I think it may be different. I'm not sure. I don't have experience with that. But maybe for everybody else, they will say you are Indian, and you need to ask them, why do you think I am an Indian? Then I think if we use that as a platform to unite all of us, I think that will be more important. I will be against using any kind of political or cultural part that will divide us for that. And that's what I'm going to tell right now today, because this is my first experience with this group. So I'm going to try to listen more and learn rather than anything.
Well done, well done.
Beautiful, well done. Okay, so Dr. Sudarshan Kapoor ji.
First of all, I really would like to thank you for selecting this topic, which is very important, no doubt. And I also want to really support Vijay Patel ji mentioned in the beginning that we are not divided all the time. There are issues where we disagree, and there are issues where we do agree. And actually, disagreements are healthy, actually. This is the way I look at it, being in a position where you disagree, so long as we disagree with respect. Many times, actually, when we disagree, we get to the level where we begin to hate people. So that's the one thing, actually, we need to avoid, that disagreement should not lead to us hating each other like that. And that's what I have noticed sometimes is happening among certain communications between certain people. If they disagree, they just simply, they adopt an attitude towards of completely hating the other person, and no communication, no agreement at all. So there are issues on which we are going to be in agreement with each other. There are going to be issues on which we will disagree. So I really want to thank you for that statement that came from Vijay Patel ji. So I really appreciate that. And so far as the unity is concerned, there are three major components of the unity as a concept. So if you look at the dictionary, it defines there are three major components. One is the spirit of togetherness, which is very important component. The other is spirit of oneness. And the third is spirit of solidarity. These are the three major components of unity as a concept. Now, so long as we keep that in mind, what unity means, and it also depends upon what issue we are talking about, what topic we are talking about, it is very possible that there is a tremendous amount of unity in respect to now the recent death of a general who took place. I think everybody feels that way. Now, when China attacked India, my goodness, actually, you could see the unity taking place all over the country. Country became one, actually, like that. Similarly, when somebody attacks India from outside, the unity comes right away, actually, whether you are Gujarati or Marathi or Punjabi, doesn't matter. So the whole country is united. It all depends upon the situation and also about the topic or an issue that we are talking about like that. Now, in respect to the farmers' agitation or Andolan that Shara Singhji very beautifully articulated, I also feel that because I am a student of Gandhi and I believe strongly in nonviolence, coming from that perspective, in my opinion, that agitation or that movement was a very nonviolent movement, actually. So actually, I would like to give that credit that the leaders who led it, though I know 700 people sacrificed their lives, and this is what does happen actually in a movement, a nonviolent movement, people should be ready to make their sacrifices like that over there. But I still consider that movement as very nonviolent, and the way it has happened, I'm very glad that the government of India has decided actually to withdraw those. I hope it leads to more and better understanding. I believe in certain principles of nonviolent conflict resolution, and one of them is that we seek understanding and friendship of the opponent. Not there is nothing like defeating the opponent or degrading the other person. No, we actually respect. This is what I always believe, that we have to maintain respect for our opponents and show all the due respect that we can, because it is a respect that actually will help us to really overcome these differences like that. I have a disagreement with a lot of people. A lot of people have very strong disagreements with me, but I never use a filthy or a dirty word to actually describe my opponents. Like, I show a lot of respect for them. So this is what I learned from Mahatma Gandhi, that if you want unity, you have to show a lot of respect for the people who disagree with you, who differ with you. And differences are always welcome, because it could lead to more positive and creative kind of idea to conflict resolution like that. I think this is what I would like to say at this time, and maybe I will come in later on this topic again. Thank you very much for this.
Okay, thank you, Sudarshan ji. Kamini ji, please. Kamini Khare. Kamini Khare, please. Yes. Kamini.
Okay. Thank you, Hari ji. Thank you. I think this is a very, very good topic and exciting topic, unity. As the professor said, when any emergency comes in India, everybody gets united. I remember a little bit about 62 war. At that time, I was a student and they were collecting the gold. So I had one ring, I just take it out and gave it to them. And so everybody was united at that time. Doesn't matter whether you are rich or poor or whoever you are, the country gets united. And country has a right to know the reality of everything. That is also is very important to get unity. If something going wrong, everybody should know, yeah, this is going wrong. Like a Kisan Andolan in India, I think Kisan, everybody say, oh, they don't understand. I wrote an article on that they're not a crazy people. They're not uneducated people. If they are saying something that this law is not good or this thing is not good, I think all the Sansad people or the Vidhayak and the minister should have heard them very early in the part of that demonstration. It took almost a whole year and 700 people died. And Khan just walked on the people. And I did not hear it from any MLA, any minister, hey, this is wrong. They're all keep telling, Kisan is wrong, Kisan is wrong, Kisan is wrong. And finally, they realize it, they're wrong, and they took the farmer law. They said, okay, they will abolish that thing. So at least they realize it. They realize it's too late. And still Kisan is fighting. I think the whole country is very, very united for that issue. That is more important issue right now. So in my opinion, whom I am talking, people are united on that issue. Some people may not be united, but most of the people are united. If any government thinks after the election, they can change the thing again, I think they think twice, because if something happened And the next Andolan said that would be bigger than this, because that time all the Mazdoor or the poor people, they will all join you, because I think children are getting educated. And international, all the media is so available to everybody. So they are looking at it. They're looking at this injustice is going on. So to unite the country, I think people should feel they are not treated wrong. So like the government makes the law, it's maybe good for 80% people, 100%, some people 50%, but the law should be good for everybody. How it affects individually, that's entirely different things. So country will unite, in India I'm talking about, here also, if anything we see something is not good, I think we all should make a point and we should speak out. Because in America, we are living here, you know, if you have emergency, you call 911, they don't ask who you are. They just ask you the address, and the ambulance is at your door in 3 minutes, sorry about it. If you go hospital, you are an emergency patient. Nobody asks whether you have insurance or not. But India, you know, if you have not paid the hospital fees, they do not release even the dead body. These are the issue. We all NRI Indians. We are NRI, we are Indians. It doesn't matter which part we are coming. And I think it's time we are all educated people, they experience what is a real democracy is, what is real rights are, we should speak out. Even sometimes America does the wrong things too. We should be able to speak about that also. Because as far as I see it, the world is, right now it's not going to be happen that you go take over somebody, some country politically. But everybody is looking to take the country economically. They will do certain rules, certain international imposition they will make, that they want to take over the economy of other people. So if we see that kind of agenda is coming in Congress or somewhere, we should speak about that also. Because we have a freedom, we're enjoying the freedom, we should use our freedom to best of the community, for whole humanity. Like the corona is everybody doing, what we can find to cure the corona, but we're not still talking about who are the culprit who brought this deadly virus for the whole world. And I think we should have courage enough to, I wrote a letter, maybe I will give it to Gary G to publish it. I really want to know is working on for the whole community. And when India comes, we should, anything is going wrong in India, we all must unite and speak out. It doesn't matter who is the government. Government will come and go. Leader will come and go. They must understand that as individual, you cannot make things wrong, which affecting thousands of people in India. I was so impressed how they had carried on their demonstration. And they had their heat, and finally the government has agreed on it, so that's good.
Thank you, Kamini ji. I'm coming to Mr. Thank Gupta you. From Michigan. Mr. And, Gupta, go ahead.
Dosto, main ethe Michigan cha, kyunki main science da student hai, science padhana hai, science nu deal kita. Main ise nationalism nu support nahi karda. Jidda Kapoor saab ne kaha vi je China da attack hove, ਪਾਕਿਸਤਾਨ ਦਾ ਠੱਗ ਹੋਵੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਸਾਰੇ ਇਕੱਠੇ ਹੋ ਜਾਂਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਉਹ ਤਾਂ ਪਾਕਿਸਤਾਨ ਦੇ ਲੋਕ ਵੀ ਇਕੱਠੇ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਨੇ ਦੇਖੋ ਜਿੱਥੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਗਲੋਬਲ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਕਰੋਨਾ ਗਲੋਬਲ ਹੈ ਅੱਜ ਦੇ ਹਾਲਾਤ ਵਰਲਡ ਦੇ ਅੰਦਰ ਹਰ ਚੀਜ਼ ਗਲੋਬਲ ਹੈ ਜੇ ਨੈਸ਼ਨਲਿਜ਼ਮ ਦਾ ਸਲੋਗਨ ਦਿਓਗੇ ਉਹ ਡੇਂਜਰਸ ਹੈ ਜਿੱਦਾਂ ਸਾਡੇ ਪ੍ਰੈਜੀਡੈਂਟ ਇੱਥੇ ਟਰੰਪ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਨੇ ਕਿਹਾ ਮੇਕ ਇਨ USA ਇੰਡੀਆ 'ਚ ਮੋਦੀ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਨੇ ਕਿਹਾ ਮੇਕ ਇਨ ਇੰਡੀਆ ਇਜ਼ ਇਟ ਪੋਸੀਬਲ ਨੈਵਰ ਪੋਸੀਬਲ ਨਾਈਦਰ USA could implement make in USA, not India Modi could implement. I was looking to figures in India, how much is the import from China today? $98 billion. I was looking figures in USA, how much import from China? $850 billion. On one side, we are talking of nationalism, Gujarati nationalism, Punjabi nationalism. It is not working. basic fight in the world is going on between the people and the corporates, big money, hedge fund managers, corporate sector. So just I give an example. JP Morgan CEO Mr. Diamond regretted that I gave a statement Chinese government, because JP Morgan has opened a branch in China. They have allowed them to operate their bank operations. So on one side, he's speaking to make the people of China happy, India, USA happy, that China is bad. And other day he regrets that China is good, is not bad. So we are in a contradictory phase of politics and economy. Today, there is a fight going on in USA, not only in India also, between the big people, big money people, and the people themselves. And that is a farmers movement in India. That is a fallout of farmers movement in India. And it was a blunder, historical blunder, that you bring a bill in parliament without any discussion in the cabinet, just only number. And you withdraw the same bill after 1 year. Economic collapse in 1 year, very. Bring the bill and without any discussion pass. It's first time happened in India, like Indira Gandhi did an emergency. So this is a model of Gujarat. I am surprised. It is an intellectual bankruptcy of the leadership of India, which did this, all these blunders. What message give to the world? Who will invest in India? Your currency is depreciating. India is today highest price inflation.
Gupta Saab, I can add here a few things. I'm working last 35 years to be India should manufacturing, should be the top in the world. Actually, it never happened. Yeah. And they don't care for NRIs. NRIs can change India very big way. 92, they did it with Manmohan Singh. It can help that. I think we should think about that. We are very professional Indian. If we have a big network here, we are united. I think every prime minister or chief minister of states will talk to us, and then we should help them to do it. Right now, we are very divided. I have very bad experience in the last 2-3 years. It's not supposed to be happen. Kashyap Patel.
It is a worth to hear all the speakers today, and they have given their different opinion right now. Sure. We are talking about unity, NRI unity.
Yeah.
Who are NRI? NRI. We consider the NRI who came from India, means Indian NRI, Indian American community. That's it. It doesn't have any one religion, no caste, no religion, no single business like that. So we are not known, when we say NRI, it is not known as one type of business person or one type of religion. Means Hindu, Sikh, or Muslim, or Isai, like that. We are that way. When we say NRI, we use the word of unity. So unity automatically is there, but reality is not there. That's correct. So I thank Gary Ji to select this topic. It is really very important topic of today, current. In current position, you can create the unity. Just Jalisa Abhib, he unhone bataya. Can we change the India? If we are united, if we work together, if we. Of course, I am not doing any business here, but I am confident of it, because this is the thing. We have that ability, we have that intelligence. Now, coming to the second point. The first point right now is that of Kisan Andolan. One thing we should remember, Bharat, Kisan Jagat ka Taat hai. Jagat, jo hum bolte hain Bharat mein, to Jagat means Bharat. Kisan Jagat ka Taat hai. Jagat ka Taat hai, isme sawal hi nahi, har ek jagah, har ek desh mein, har koi khana peene, agar हम एक दिन कमाई नहीं करेंगे, एक दिन गेम नहीं खेलेंगे तो चलेगा, खाने के लिए चलेगा नहीं, तो ये खाना आता है कहाँ से? तो किसान देते हैं। तो किसान क्या है? तो ये किसान की हिफाजत करना, उनकी वेलफेयर के लिए देखना, वो हर एक का धर्म है। जैसे यहाँ बोलते हैं ना, कस्टमर इज राइट ऑलवेज, व्हाई? बिकॉज ही इज पेइंग, ही इज शॉपिंग एंड ही इज गिविंग सम मनी एंड वी आर गेटिंग सम मुनाफा उसमें से, और मुनाफा में से हमें पगार मिलता है, तो कि दैट कस्टमर इज अवर गॉड। दिस इज दिस इज स्टेटमेंट ऑफ अमेरिका, व्हाई? दैट इज दैट। So wherever there is our benefit, we should respect the thing. So why not किसान? किसान को तो इतना सम्मान मिलना चाहिए कि मेरे दिल से तो मैं चाहता हूँ कि हर एक पॉलिटिशियन को तो सोचना ही पड़ेगा, लेकिन हर एक बिजनेस वाले को भी सोचना पड़े कि वो किसान का शोषण करके बिजनेस बड़ा करना न चाहना चाहिए। तो कॉरपोरेट की जो बात कर दें, वो कॉरपोरेट इस तरह से नहीं, जैसे कि वो पवार साहब जो कहते हैं कि उनके जो जिस तरह से उन्होंने मनी बनाए, नॉट दैट वे, वी शुड विच देयर शुड बी कंट्रोल ओवर द कॉर्पोरेट ऑल्सो एंड ईच एवरी पार्ट ऑफ एपीएमसी और एवरीथिंग, सो दैट दे शुड नॉट वर्क आउट ऑफ द रूल्स एंड दे शुड नॉट वर्क अगेंस्ट द बेनिफिट ऑफ किसान। किसान के बिना चलेगा नहीं, क्योंकि लाल बहादुर शास्त्री ने 1965 में लाल बहादुर शास्त्री ने यही सूत्र दिया था, जय जवान जय किसान। क्यों? ये दो बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट है। आज रात को, हर एक रात को मैं शाम को सोते समय भगवान की प्रार्थना करता हूँ और भगवान को एक ही बात बोलता हूँ कि बॉर्डर, हमारे देश के बॉर्डर पर जो जवान भारत के सुरक्षा के लिए काम कर रहे हैं, उनकी रक्षा करना, उनको सेफ रखना।
ओके, थैंक यू। ओके कश्मीरी, थैंक यू जी। पटेल साहब, बजिंदर सर, सिद्धू साहब, बजिंदर जी प्लीज।
यस सर, थैंक यू। एंड आई विल बी वेरी सिंपल एंड शॉर्ट। वी नो व्हाट स्टेटस को इज, एंड फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल व्हेन आई लुक एट इंडियंस, वी हैव बिकम फ्रॉम डिफरेंट स्टेटस, डिफरेंट स्टेट्स, एंड we should be saying we are all Indians are equal. There is nobody more Indian than others. Yeah. Okay, because when farmers were holding the protest, are you with me? Then some of the people were voicing in favor of the farmers, while other communities were voicing in favor of the Indian government. So we NRIs here in US, we were taking sides. So my first appeal to everybody is that we are all NRIs, we live here, we should not take sides. We should look at respect the other people and work here from our life here. Now, on the other hand, look at the politician. Politician in November 2020 made one statement, and the second statement in November 2021 changed the whole scenario.
Yeah.
So politician changed so fast. So we should not be influenced by the politician back home and take our responsibility to respect each other and accept each other's ideas and try to work together rather than be influenced by those politicians back home. And now, first of all, I want to pay tribute, and I'm so glad, but farmers have brought a vibration of, you know, excitement throughout India. The whole India's whole masses are now at a different level of you know, understanding for the whole country, how the farmers, workers, and as Shaurya Singh says, Chetna, the simple word Chetna is really the wonderful thing they have transmitted throughout the Indian nation. Right. So I really thankful to the farmers keeping non-violent, peaceful, and brought this change, which is a permanent change for years to come.
Yes.
On the other hand, I also want to thank Modi because he took the opportunity. He captured the moment and made the decision. And all of a sudden, look at the country, how we feel good about everything. Just farmers are leaving. The local people are hugging them, crying them. So just one statement on part of the leader, a good statement has made such a big change. So I learned this lesson that as a NRI, I will not be influencing, you know, if one state people, one religion people are protesting for the rights, I will never make a negative comment. We should always stay positive. and let's see, let's respect them, see what they're doing. At the same time, yes, we watch them, but at the same time, take the responsibility of not getting excited with what's happening over there. So from a practical point of view, these are the 2 points I want to carry, because generally we Indians are very philosophical and we always say we should do this, we should do that, we should do that. Who's going to do actually? We do ourselves. So do something, take the responsibility. Thank you.
Okay, Bajinder ji. Peshawara Singh ji, you have any question to anyone? I think you have heard everybody. Amrik Sidhu ji will be get a conclusion at the end there. Actually, they always do it. Peshawara Singh ji, can you ask anybody any question there? Anything?
No, I don't have any question, but I just have observations.
Okay.
I would like to comment on Vijay Patil's idea. You know, he gave a. He had wonderful, he made wonderful points. But one point he made, and I want to make a suggestion to him. He said he doesn't know much about India, and he's not very much interested to know about Indian politics either, because he doesn't know about it. I think when Kamini said here that all these organizations, we should write the Indian word before whatever we write. And when we say we are NRIs, that means, you know, India is not going to go away from us for a long time, it seems to me. So if you don't know much about Indian politics or Indian, divided or not divided, start Googling and reading about this Sanjukta Kisan Morcha and how they won it. And it's a good thought to say, Patilji, that we are NRI, that we are not an undivided community. It's a very good thought for you and I, probably, and most of the people in their heart of hearts, they do believe that they are not divided. But, and so was in India. But was it true with the Indian government? Can you imagine that if you watch this whole scenario, they were betting their money on the division of Indians?
Yes.
They thought that the nation will never come together and this protest will never gel all those people. They thought, just to begin with, when the protesters moved from Punjab, the government was betting that that their BJP government in Haryana will not let them pass Simpu border. But to their surprise, to their great surprise, I would say to their shock, the Haryana community, Haryana people, met them like brothers, and they said, "You know, we are brothers who had been torn apart," and they embraced each other. And the Haryana said, "Well, you follow us now. And if our state government is building barricades, we will break them. And you follow us. You don't do anything." And this is how, you know, Haryana joined them, and then the UP joined them, and then Rajasthan joined them, Madhya Pradesh joined them, and the rest of India joined them. So you can't say we are not undivided here, or we were not undivided there. We were undivided. We were heavily divided.
Now we are united. Okay. Let me say that. Vijay Patil, I think you are highly involved with the BJP. I know that. I know you very well. You are a good friend of mine also. Do you involve BJP here very big way, right? That's very good. Secretary or something. I know you are an organizer, right?
Yeah, used to be in the past. So let me clarify. The great point, Pisharaji Singh Parji. I really appreciate it, and I really admire that. We all should do our part in knowing about what's happening. And as Garaji said, I was involved in consistency of BJP activities for a few years until 2017.
I don't know. Okay.
I had seen it closely. I also did Google, right, all the farmers' movement and everything.
Okay.
But I'm with Bajinder Sindhu Paji ji. There are two sides of the stories. And both the sides are it's a balanced view, right? There's one side will basically say, okay, this is the viewpoint. Other side will exactly have contrary.
Okay.
So when I made a comment saying, I really do not know enough to take side. And let me clarify that. I really do not know, have enough knowledge to take one side or the other, right? So I understand the facts. There was an announcement about the bill. And the bill was taken out, and there was a farmers' movement in between. Completely get it. right? But I'm not a political expert to say what happened and why this happened. I admire the outcome. Like Paji said, Bajinder Paji said, admire the outcome. Outcome is unity. After all this, what we did, we all united. And I think you said that the farmers were hugging with the local people, right? That's really a tremendous sense of unity. No question about it.
Thank you. Dr. Manoj Shah, please. Your time. Please keep everybody 1 minute, not more than that, please. Then Barki Sidhu had to close for that, please.
I would really like to go out and find one thing that we all can unite under. I know one of the things is Mr. Patilji said about kind of looking at Indian heroes. You know, that's one thing we can use to get united under. There are other things, but we will like to get united under things that we will like to look for NRIs. You know, we will not like to go back and look at India or Indian heroes or something. We want to find something here that will unite all of us. So we go ahead and look. Most of the time we can get kind of united if we all face the problem. If it's like kind of somebody said before that war against China, then everybody get united. So if you have any problem that we all face as Indians, if we can unite to fight that problem, we created that problem here by talking about it.
Yeah, you're right.
We should not be talking about Indian politics here because I mean, you know, I just wrote in chat box, any politics really is like fighting in a mud.
Okay, go ahead. Pisharaj, take only 1 minute, then Jeevan Gill has to come, then Kamini Khare, please. One minute, please. Thank you.
Just very quickly to answer Manoj Shah's question, that if he's looking for one single issue where not only the NRIs can unite, but I think the whole world is uniting or can unite. That is what Dr. Gupta said. The real issue in it was not that Mazdoor Kisan issue alone.
Yes.
Don't forget it. That issue belongs to us. That belongs to anybody. And that issue is that the fight between corporate and the democratic rights of individuals. Yes. Now, Vijay Patil is saying that I'm not the one who is going to choose sides. I think one day you got to choose sides, but you got to be very careful which side you choose, because the narrative has been set in India by the Kisan Andolan, corporate versus democratic rights at the cost of more than 700 lives and 1 year protest sleeping on the roads. And that narrative also being set here in America, as I mentioned in my introduction, in the city of Seattle by a young Indian born city councillor, Kashama Savant, who is fighting against the corporate money in her city. So there is an issue. Go think about it.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Jeevan Gilji, 1 minute, please. We have to close it.
I think that one issue we are talking about, I think this is what like the corporate world is like one of the bigger issue we have to start with, because that is where our differences are coming. The richer are going to get more richer. If you are in a rich category, you can be, don't worry about anything. But the more population is going into the poor population, that is where the unity play the role. Either you can see the wars of when the Rajas get together to fight against the bigger Rajas. That is where like this is still standing there. The corporatist world is going to take us over everybody, and then we are not then a very slim chances of get together. I think if any as Manoji said, like the issue, we can start working on that end. Like let's bring it. If we can bring it politically, yes, there are different faces where you grown up or where you spend more of your time. As Patil G said, like their kids, my kids are grown up here. They feel they are Canadian, and we're still trying to invite them to our culture and language to that one. But bigger to me, as a politically, I look into that, the corporate world is going to take over us. Unless you are in that category in 1%, otherwise you are going to go out, you are going to run away for your food. That is what, like I said earlier, that we have to learn from the Kansan Dolan, because they are losing the properties. That is what we take a good point from that end and implement on us, the how we can make a change to the system. This is a political system. We have to, either you have to be come with a good ideas and fight with the politics.
Okay, Kamini ji, then it's your turn. Okay. Kamini ji, please.
All right. Thank you.
Then Mr. Kapoor will come.
Yeah, I have just two points to make, and if everybody agrees, I will think I did a good job.
Okay.
Two things. I think we NRI can unite for two things. भारत माता को हम सब भारत माता की जय बोलते हैं, टाइम टाइम पे हर समय बोलते हैं, और जस्ट टू रिस्पेक्ट भारत माता, इफ वी कैन डू दैट, वी शुड ऑल प्रोटेक्ट द डेमोक्रेसी इन इंडिया. भारत को कम से कम 100 साल से ज़्यादा लगे थे आज़ादी को मिलने के लिए. उस आज़ादी पे हम कोई अंकुश बर्दाश्त नहीं करना चाहते हैं और ना करना चाहिए. अगर हम सब यूनाइट हो जाए कि हम भारत की आज़ादी को किसी प्रकार से कम नहीं होने देंगे, भारत माता की जय हम बोलते हैं और बोलते रहेंगे, ये हमारे देशवासियों ने कितनी कुर्बानियां दी हैं इस आज़ादी के लिए. और आज़ादी के नेता किसने गलत किया, किसने सही किया, इस पर हम नहीं डिबेट करना चाहते हैं, क्योंकि जिस समय जो नेता होता है वो अपने दिमाग से सही सोच के ही काम करता है. तो सावरकर खराब थे या भगत सिंह खराब थे या नेहरू जी खराब थे, इस विषय पे आर्गुमेंट करने से कोई हमें कुछ फायदा नहीं होगा. अब जो सिचुएशन है, आने वाले कल को हम कैसे प्रोटेक्ट करें, आज उस पर बात करने की जरूरत है. तो हम अपनी आजादी को किस तरीके से प्रोटेक्ट करें हर व्यक्ति के लिए, ये आज आवश्यक है. और दूसरी बात, इकोनॉमिक के लिए मैं बात करूंगी कि भारत को वर्ल्ड की मार्केट प्लेस ना बनने दिया जाए. आज सारी कंट्री हमारे देश में क्यों आना चाहती है, वो अपना सामान बेचना चाहती है. बस इसलिए हमारी गवर्नमेंट पे, अगर गवर्नमेंट की गलत पॉलिसीज करती है, वी आर शुड स्पीक आउट. वी नीड इंडस्ट्रीज, वी डोंट वांट टू बी ए मार्केट प्लेस. एंड राइट नाउ इंडिया की इंडस्ट्रीज क्यों बंद हो गई, छोटे छोटे धंधे बंद हो गए, कि चाइना का माल इतना डंप हो गया, इतना चीप था, हमने इंडस्ट्री खत्म हो गई. तो भारत को इकोनॉमिकली हम किसी की स्लेव ना बनने दें और अपनी आज़ादी पे अंकुश ना लगने दें, वो चाहे कोई भी लीडर हो, हमको इससे लीडर से कोई मतलब नहीं है.
चल, हो गया.
हर आदमी की आज़ादी प्रोटेक्ट रहनी चाहिए. अगर इस पे हम सब NRI इकट्ठे हो जाएं,
हाँ,
तो हम समझते हैं अपने भारत के लिए बहुत बड़ा काम करेंगे.
ब्यूटीफुल कामी, थैंक यू जी. डॉक्टर कपूर जी प्लीज, डॉक्टर कपूर जी क्लोजिंग जी, क्लोजिंग प्लीज इन वन मिनट एवरीबॉडी.
Yeah,
thank you.
Well, I really enjoyed the discussion and the conversation that is going on. I have three points that I would like to share with you. One is about the issue that probably is being mentioned in the corporate culture. It's not going to be easy to deal with that. Capitalism and corporate culture is going to be very difficult. I would suggest another issue for consideration, the climate issue. The climate issue actually is a very important issue at present, which is affecting all of us throughout the globe like that. So that may be something that we should consider. I have a feeling all of us will get united very quickly that it is affecting all of us. Other issues like corporate culture and like that, it's not going to be easy. Capitalism is going to stay here. It's not going to go away, let me tell you. So issues like climate issues here, we can all get together. That would be something we should consider there. The other point is about the heroes. I certainly support the idea of knowing our heroes, but at the same time, I also support the idea of learning about heroes of other countries and culture. For example, here, we should know about George Washington. We should know about Abraham Lincoln. We should know about Luther King. We should know Nelson Mandela. We should know about Cesar Chavez. Hmm. So we should actually also consider knowing actually about these heroes also, include them also, not just, and keep our mind open actually like that.
Yeah.
And the third point is actually that we should actually work in a manner where, which I call dialogue, not a debate actually. Debates do not lead us to any solution. dialogue is a much better term, actually, where both the parties actually listen to us, each other actively and without any threat, without any danger, can communicate with each other. So let us promote dialogue and also try to seek common grounds where we can work together. We are going to have differences, different opinion, but we need to seek common grounds, because this is where people can work together. Are there any common grounds in this issue that we can work together, and also a win-win situation rather than a win-lose situation? So I promote win-win situation rather than win-lose situation. Thank you very much for having me.
Thank you, everybody. Amrik Sidhu ji, please, how do you feel that? Amrik Sidhu, are you ready?
Thank you, ji. I want to thank Gary ji for bringing the panel together. We're talking about NRIs are not united. Look at this. We are united. We have a voice together. How united need to be. And I want to make a few very simple points. The problem is of the NRIs is that we don't have a problem. That's why we can't get together, because we don't have a problem.
You're right.
So how are we going to get behind it? The good thing is that we are, like Sudarshan Kapoor ji said, that we are in, kind of engaged in this dialogue. Dialogue is the best way to get people talking to each other and expelling any myths and fear about the other side. And about the Kisan Andolan, that I think was long overdue. That is the best thing that happened to India. That woke India up. It brought India together. And at the same time, Kamini made a very good point about Jai Bharat Mata Ki. What I want to ask here is, what is Bharat Mata?
Yes.
Bharat Mata is not a piece of land. It's a people of Bharat.
Yes.
Bharat Mata is all its people. So what we need to do is, we could have differences of opinions. We can follow. Politicians love to divide us. We need to be mindful about politicians. They will find an issue of race. They will find an issue of jat pat. They will find an issue of region, religion, you name it. They will find it, and they will divide us. They do it everywhere in the world, not just in India. So we need to be mindful. We need to be very, very mindful when politicians divide us. Corporate and public sector. Now, in India, why we're not be thinking about what are we going to do if we corporate our farming sector? Where are we going to find jobs for all those millions of people who will be displaced? No. They're earning a living from small farms. India does not have employment for all of those.
Yes.
Are we looking at mass unemployment in India? Is that what we want? So when we support a government that is against its farmers, we didn't think that what it would do if the farmers were displaced. So I want to thank you all for coming together and stay together. And think that what these politicians are after, that's what will keep us united. And I want to thank you again. Back to you, Gary.
Thank you very much. I'm closing out now here. For the most 30 years, I'm highly involved with politicians in India, but I got a conclusion. NRI is the smartest people in the world. They are highly involved aerospace, like Amrik Sidhu ji, Bajinder Sidhu ji, IBM, Jeevan Gill ji, big politician, his mama ji, Toronto, 5 times a member of parliament, Malli saab. So we have all kind of people here, professors, scientists. So we must have a network. Every city, if we have a 15, 20 people, New York 20 people, Los Angeles 20 people, does not matter which caste we are, does not matter which religion we are. If we are a 20 people in city, we are making a big network. I can guarantee you that politicians will be after you. They will ask suggestions, but they need improvement in India. So anyway, thank you very much for coming. But thank you very much. Okay, good night, everybody. Thank you.
Good night, everybody.
Thank you, everyone. Good night.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Kamini ji, getting involved, actually being there, because I was looking at there all men. Actually, you are representing our sisters also on this panel. Thank you.
Thank you.